has balls?
Yeah, they were weird looking. Jeez.
What a weirdo.
I mean, who pushes a sled up their driveway? Obviously, I'd say weirdo, but you say it not for the both of us.
Yeah.
You guys play here too? Weird. Hey everybody, welcome to Dadlifting, where I plan to dispense wisdom about fitness, and family. I'm just a regular guy with a gym in his garage, three kids, and a regular desk job. So I'm just trying to figure out this whole YouTube thing. So as I do, it might be fun to A, like this video, and B, maybe subscribe to the channel so you can cringe along with me as I figure it all out. I got some links in the description below to my website and a few other places where you can read things that I put out on fitness and where you can expect to see things in the future. So anyway, on to the video. Today's video is about why I shouldn't start a YouTube channel. Five reasons I should not start a YouTube channel. It's really a reflection on the self-doubt that I've gone through as I've thought about after I bought the camera, but before I actually launched the YouTube channel, about why I shouldn't do it, or maybe why I should. So, number one, nobody's gonna watch. And that's a big one. It's likely that no one will watch for a long time, and that's fine. It's not about that at the beginning. It can't be about that in the beginning. And it's okay that it's not gonna be about views or anything else. It's gonna be about passion and putting out content that I like. On to the second reason not to start a YouTube channel. It's just general embarrassment. So the embarrassment would be like, what if my friends find out? What if people at work find out I have a YouTube channel? Won't they think I'm weird? Won't people that know me as someone who wasn't into fitness or who was not so, out there in the public, won't they think I'm weird? Won't neighbors think I'm weird? And my reaction to that is they already think I'm super weird. I'm already the guy who, when I go on business trips, pulls out hard-boiled eggs from his backpack and eats those instead of going to a restaurant. I'm the guy who pulls out Brussels sprouts from his backpack instead of, just ordering whatever is on the menu at some restaurant. So I'm already weird at work. I'm the guy who's in there eating tuna with mustard on it in the break room. Just gross things that people find odd. I'm eating at odd times of the day. I'm fasting for long periods. I'm an odd guy. So I'm not really concerned about that. The neighbors already think I'm crazy weird. They make strange noises in the garage. I do all that stuff. My kids are cool with my weirdness, so it's all good. Everybody's a little weird, and I'm not embarrassed by it. So that's number two, and I'm okay with that. Number three, privacy concerns, especially for my children. So I'm worried that maybe their likeness will get out there, and it might be bad for them in some way that I'm exploiting my children on this YouTube channel that A, nobody's watching. So that's one thing. So it's not really a privacy concern if no one watches. So that kind of checks that off. Second, I can just blur over the face here or put some other likeness on top of the face so you can't even tell what he looks like. So that's fine. And everyone's really supportive within the house about, me pursuing this as a creative outlet. So I'm happy about that. So that kind of takes care of that. Number four, the YouTube channel will be a waste of time and money. It definitely will be a waste of money, but it won't be a lot of money. It's not going to cost much money to put up YouTube videos on an ongoing basis. And in terms of the grand scheme of things, this is definitely a midlife crisis, so I don't view it as a waste of time because that's something that I want to explore. And I view it as not a waste of money because it's not nearly as expensive as like a boat or a sports car or, a divorce, for example. Oops, never mind. Just kidding. So I don't view it as a waste of time or money. I think I'm okay with that. Number five, and this is the big one, is that I don't have anything fresh or interesting to say about fitness that hasn't already been said, that isn't already out there. And this is one that I think probably has the most credence. So I don't have this amazing physique. I don't have, you know, Instagram model looks. I don't have, you know, a PhD in anything related to training or nutrition. I'm just a guy who's seen a lot of YouTube videos and who's read a lot of content on the internet. So I'm dangerous in that way, but, you know, hopefully some of it can just come across, some of my stuff that I can be just more relatable to people like me that are 35 years old, have kids, have, you know, jobs, and they're trying to fit fitness into all that. So maybe I can add some perspective there. But this is the challenge that's going to be the hardest for me to overcome. And it's one that I'm excited to face on a daily basis and to get, you know, new content and fresh content and just think of different ways to do things. So that's it. That's number five. And that is the entire list, the five reasons I should not start a YouTube channel. But, spoiler alert, I did start a YouTube channel. You're watching it right now. And I'm going to keep putting out some videos for the next year or so. The goal with the YouTube channel is to get to around 1,000 subscribers in the next 12 months, or maybe by the end of 2020. So that's the goal. So it seems like, you know, a pretty big goal now with just no subscribers, but it's a goal I think I can reach in a year. So we'll see. I'll keep posted on how that's going. And you can obviously watch along and subscribe if you like. But in closing, I'm going to throw the five reasons I should start a YouTube channel at you really quickly. So number one, learn new skills, editing, filming, being just creative in general, coming up with ways to express myself in ways that I haven't been able to before. That's great. Number two, gaining confidence, gaining repetitions, gaining the ability to speak out in public, or just, you know, improving on all those things. Number three, joining a community, you know, connecting with like-minded individuals. It's been a long time since I've made a friend. Probably the last friend I made was a friend I found on YouTube, I mean on Twitter, actually. One of the guys who followed me, and we connected, and now we're buddies. But beyond that, it's been years, probably since high school, since I've really gotten a lifelong or a lasting friendship that was deep on any kind of level. So hopefully just the internet can make that process a lot easier just by finding people that are like-minded and you know, want to connect on items that I'm interested in, like fitness. So that makes it easier. So that's number three, joining a community, connecting with the fitness world. Number four, have fun with my kids. Model behavior that I want them to have in the future so they can look back on these times when dad was really into fitness for a little while and he had a garage gym, and wasn't it cool how he followed his passion and he started a YouTube channel and he started a blog and did all this cool stuff. Wasn't that fun? And, you know, hopefully they can reflect on that, and then when they have passions that are a little bit out of the norm, they'll feel like they can pursue those as well. So that's number four. And then number five would be kind of the most, I guess, out there one, which is, what if people do watch? What if I do find a following? What if you guys do? What if I get better at this to the point where people care about what I put out on a weekly or whatever basis I end up putting out videos? What if people do show up? And how would I know that if I didn't try? So obviously I have to start a YouTube channel. I have started one. So join me in this journey, and we'll see where it goes. All right? Anyway, thanks, and as always,
eat more cheeseburgers.
Keep it on the DL.